Hey everyone, I am back today with a new coloring book and a short, condensed sort of color and chat. So this is the new book by Emily Oberg. You guys know I have her fairy tales book. It's one of my favorite books to color in, and this has not been released in the US yet, and I had to have me a copy. So I ordered it from Printworks, and I got it in less than a week. I was shocked that it came in so fast, but it came in about 4 business days, which was really awesome. And the book is really similar to her other book. The style of drawing and all that is similar. And there are flip-throughs of this. I can do a flip-through if you'd like to see it. But like I said, the style of pictures and drawing is really pretty much the same. But the pictures are adorable. I love coloring in her books. The paper is like the Hannah Carlson books. And the only difference between this book and her previous one, Fairy Tales, and I think this is called like Fairy Tales Ever After or something like that. I don't remember what it's called, so I apologize. But the only thing that's different is this has a hard cover instead of a paper cover, which the American Fairy Tales came with a paper cover. So I've already started this picture, as you can tell, and I wanted to continue on and do a little color and chat with you guys today. Just chat with you a little bit, catch up, let you know what's been going on aside from my streams, because if you've watched my color and chats on my Instagram streams, you see that I'm still coloring and uploading my pictures and all that kind of thing, but I haven't done a proper color and chat for a while. So I'm going to zoom in here so that way you can see what I'm doing. I have a new sharpener that I'm using. This is this. It's a Japanese sharpener, and it sharpens really nice. I find it works really well for Prismacolors. It also works for the, I'm using the Polychromos on this. It has this little opening, and you can adjust it to the size that you want. So whatever the size is that you want, that's how you work. So I'm just working with that right now. I still am using my other sharpeners, but this one I'm just taking with me at the moment because I just got it. And as I said, I'm using my Polychromos. So right now I'm just going to go in and color the leaves, and I'm just starting them, and I'm trying to look at the name on this because it's very hard to see. Light Falto Flato Green. I don't know, and I can't see the number either. It's 3, nope, it's 162, I think. They really need to get a better system because I can't see the numbers and what it says. But anyway. So, yeah, you guys may have noticed there's been a lack of videos on this channel. I've been very active with our Facebook group. I'm actually set up for buddy colors until August now. So I have a buddy color every week until August. And if anybody would like to do a buddy color with me, please just come let me know on the Facebook page and we can set up a date. Typically what I like you to do is pick a book and I'll pick a picture, or if you have something specific in mind in both areas, we can do that. I'm pretty open to everything, so. So I'm staying real active on the Facebook page, so if you follow me over there, you'll know that I'm still alive. Let me take a sip here, I'm really thirsty. If you guys don't have you a Yeti cup, you need to get one of these bad boys. Let me tell you something. I went to the doctor yesterday, and I was in there for over 2 hours, and I left my cup of water in the car. And on Long Island yesterday, it was 102 degrees. At least that's what it was in my car when I got in the car. And once I got closer to the water, it cooled down a little bit. But I happened to be on the North Shore yesterday, and it was 102 degrees up there, so that was pretty hot. And I had left my Yeti in the car. I didn't think I was going to be in the office for that amount of time. But I still had ice cold water when I came out. If that is not like the best invention ever, I don't know what is. And on the other side of it, it'll keep your coffee warm too. Now, of course, in 102 degree weather, your coffee's gonna keep warm, let's be honest. But in cold weather, it'll keep your coffee warm. It's like the greatest cup I ever had. I was so impressed with it. I said, Frank, you need one of these. And we went out and I bought him one. I was like, you have to have this because his coffee's always getting cold on him. So I was like, this is like a necessity for you. So we got him one and now he loves it and he's only using that too. So very useful little contraptions, I must say. I had never heard of it before, and then when we went to Florida, our friends came to visit us. They live down there, and they said they had left their Yetis in the car, and their water was still cold. And I was like, how in the hell did your water stay cold in Florida weather? I'm standing here melting. How did you leave your water in your car for like 6 hours and it was still cold? Well, they had Yetis. So I said, I need to try this thing out. And Frank found them for me one day when he went to the hardware store. So he brought one home and I tried it. And now you know the story of the Yeti. So if you don't have one and you like to have cold drinks and keep them cold for a long time, definitely get you one. So I wanted to just give you guys a brief little update about what's going on. So you know that I've mentioned to you that filming has become a little bit difficult for me with Mr. Emilio because he's talking a whole lot more now. He's into everything even more than he was before. We're going through the terrorizing twos right now where we tantrum over who knows what. I don't even think he knows what. And it's quite stressful because he's screaming at the top of his lungs and we have no clue why. But, you know, I did some reading and found that this is a normal thing for children. So we're trying to work with him on it, you know, and, you know, I don't know. Trying to just deal with it as best we can and cannot wait till the ever-loving day when this phase passes. I cannot even tell you. But for those of you guys that are not on the Facebook page, I wanted to just tell you what was going on as well. So I have been experiencing, as you guys know, on and off, some really, really bad pain, like much worse than I've ever experienced before. And I talked to my pain management doctor about it, and he said, you know, I think we need to go get you some tests, because we can't treat something if we don't know if there's something more there or not. And we can't just keep putting Band-Aids on things if we don't even know what we're putting the Band-Aid on, if there's something there. So I totally agreed with him, and it took me a month actually to get an appointment with the rheumatologist, but I did finally, and I went yesterday, and they did some blood work, and I've obviously, it's only a day, so I don't have those results yet. She's checking for everything, all kinds of autoimmune diseases, thyroid, all that kind of stuff. But I did get an initial diagnosis, and I kind of did think that she was going to tell me this, to be quite honest with you. But, you know, I'm not a medical professional, so I can't make a diagnosis. But I have psoriatic arthritis. And right now it's the worst that it really could be. My body is completely inflamed. I have swelling in my fingers, my ankle, my toes. You guys may have remembered a while ago, I talked to you about that I have dry skin on some of my fingers. Well, you can probably see today they are very red and swollen, these fingers and this one. I have it on all three fingers. And that is the arthritis working on me. So she said to me, based on, you know, my conversation with her, which I'm not going to tell all the details because, you know, my healthcare stuff, what I do for my treatments and stuff is private, but I told her, you know, how I work with my pain management doctor, what kind of exercising I do, and that actually I haven't been able to do any exercising at all because I'm at that point where although exercising will help the stiffness, it makes me swell up. And she completely understood what I was talking about as far as that goes. She said, you know, it's a very fine line. She said, you're at that line that you can't cross at this point. You cannot overdo it. She explained to me a little bit more about the disease. It's a progressive disease, and I'm more at risk to have tendon tears, obviously the swelling, the inflammation, the pain, all that kind of thing. We don't know if there's anything else lurking around within, but hopefully the blood tests will tell us one way or the other. But as far as this goes, the medicines for this are kind of scary, and one of my really, really good informed people here gave me a whole lot of information. So before I had even went to the office, I had a good idea of what was available for treatment. So unfortunately, there's no cure. There's just treatment. And I'll be honest with you, I didn't care for this doctor all that much. I thought she was well informed, and I did believe she knew what she was talking about. It was just her in general I did not like. So I'm not going to be seeing her again. And she was going to be sending my blood test results to my pain management doctor anyway, who is like the man. And I love that guy and trust him completely. And I know he will lead me in the right direction once I see him. And I'm going to be seeing him very soon again. But so it all doesn't sound that bad, except that obviously my joints can grow. What's the word I'm looking for? My joints can grow funny, so I can throw things out of joint really easily, or they can get deformed or disfigured or something like that. As the disease progresses, if inflammation is not brought down, or who knows, you know, everybody's different, so everybody's going to experience things differently. The thing that bothered me the most about the visit and what something I was just completely not expecting. They have this thing called a grip test where you like grip this thing called a handlebar. And according to her, I mean, I never heard of this, I didn't know anything about it, but according to her, it was to see how much function and strength I have and grip I have in my hands. And I've lost already 50% of that in my hands. So, I don't know if you guys that have kids experienced this when you were pregnant, but I knew, I had read about it, that you can experience dropping things a lot when you're pregnant. And I did. I certainly did. When I was first pregnant, I was dropping everything on the floor. And although it wasn't so bad at the beginning, when you have a huge round belly at 9 months and you're dropping crap on the floor constantly, it's a little hard to pick it up. So I had to get Frank all the time to help me pick it up. And I assumed that it was going to go away once I gave birth. And unfortunately, it never really did. And to be honest with you, it's something that had been on my mind for a while. I do have problems opening things. I drop things frequently. And I was like, what the heck is going on here, you know? I don't physically feel any different in my hands other than the fact that they hurt all the time. But I don't feel like I've lost grip until about a week and a half ago. I said to Frank, I feel like I'm losing strength in my hands. And, you know, I have so many things, it's hard to know what the heck is going on with me. So this test confirmed it. That is what it is. Now, she did say that when and if the inflammation goes down, I can get some of that back, but I won't get all of it back. It's been damaged for way too long. Her hypothesis is that I've been suffering with this for years and no one knew about it because I didn't have any warning signs. Like, the biggest warning sign is the skin thing, and I haven't had that. She said the reason now I'm getting the problem with the skin is because it's at its worst state. My body is so inflamed that the skin now is showing the signs of it. So that was the trigger that she knew right away that this is what it was. And like I said, it's something that I considered myself. So that wasn't a complete shock. The loss of use of the muscles and strength in my hands was a shock and hard to take. Let's just put it like that. So, you know, I'm dealing with it. I'm still new to, I mean, this only happened yesterday. So I'm still new to the whole thing and trying to take it in and understand that my coloring assistant is here and then he's going to make noise. No, I'm still new to the idea of this whole thing that, you know, life is going to be different for me and my family, and we're going to have to find ways to deal with it. I have a cookie. That's right. You got yourself a cookie. Very good. Mm-hmm. Yum. So as you can hear now, little Emilio is starting to say words. So you may hear instead of just babble all the time words. So that's a nice thing. I'm waiting for the day for him to curse, because I'm sure it's going to be coming soon. Because I know it'll be when someplace where I can't like edit it out or something like that. It will be like in a supermarket or something, but hey, whatever. Anyway, getting back to my story. So it was a little bit difficult to take, and it's going to obviously be an adjustment for me. I'm going to be limited more now. It's, you know, life will just be a little bit more of a challenge for me than it was before. But I'm not going to let it get me down. It might throw me off a little bit for a second, which it is doing at this moment. I have to be honest with you. After my appointment yesterday, besides multiple things that happened with this doctor, which is the reason I won't go back to her, which I'm not going to talk about, but, you know, you've lived with pain your whole life, and now you're about to probably experience more or worse or something different to go along with it, more symptoms and things like that. It's tough, you know? So anyway, this is the point that it gets on number 5. So it's pretty nice. Anyhow, so that's basically what I'm doing right now. Just adjusting to the fact that this is what is going on. This is a new part of my health and something else I'm going to have to take care of and be aware with and deal with the challenges of, which I will with my family. And I did post about some of this on the Facebook page, and everybody that, you know, responded and everything, you guys are just amazing. That's why I love our Facebook page so, so much, because it's not just a place for coloring. Yeah, that's how it got started, but we're all starting to just become so comfortable and so friendly with each other. We're sharing things about our lives and get together for support when we need it, provide it to others when, you know, they need it. It's just so lovely. It's such a comforting place to go. And even though I haven't been filming, I've been going there. I go there multiple times a day to post or to comment on people's pictures or see what's going on, you know, what the news is and stuff. And I love it. It's a source of comfort, and it's a way for me to keep in contact with you guys. So if anybody that's watching this is not a part of our Facebook group and would like to be a part of it, just go to Reading with Pugs Coloring, and you can find it, and the link will be down below. But just type in Reading with Pugs Coloring, and my picture will come up, and just request to join. But, yeah, so, you know, it's a little bit difficult. She said my weight was fine. She said, you know, everything is proportioned well as far as that goes. I mean, it never hurts to lose weight, but she didn't tell me I need to lose weight or anything. The only thing she did suggest, she said, you know, if you can, try to avoid sugar, because that's going to exacerbate it. So, you know, I have been doing that, but I guess I could do it a little bit more. I'll never be like gluten-free or anything like that. It's just not going to happen. I'm not going to set myself up for failure. I already know that I will fail if I say I'm going to do that. So I'm not going to do that, but I can try to limit myself a little bit more, and then, you know, sugar will be a splurge. But on the other side of that, and I've seen it more times than not, people that totally cut out sugar from their diet, should they go back to have sugar, they have awful, awful side effects from it. I mean, it really hits their body hard. So I don't want that, because I know that I can't totally give up sugar. I can't give up sugar in my coffee. You know, I can't totally give up cookies or anything, or cakes and stuff. I'm not going to do that kind of thing. I will limit more what I do, but I'm not going to totally give it up. Okay, now I'm going in with this one, which is the dark Falto, I don't know, green number 264. Should get a white pencil out too. Okay, I'll use this one. So that's where we stand right now. So with the hand muscle function loss, life's going to be a little bit more difficult for me, and I know it. It already is more difficult for me, and it's just going to be a little bit harder still. But like I said, it's not going to get me down. I have been kind of unmotivated to film, just because I feel like crap all the time. Yeah. So as I was saying, so yeah, since I feel like crap all the time, I don't feel like filming a lot of the times. I'm just not up to it, and, you know, standing around hurts. And the way I explained it to Frank is everything, including showering and washing my hair, seems overwhelming to me right now. And the stupidest part of it is that I've been trying to convince myself that I'm just lazy, that I don't, there's nothing really wrong with me, I'm just lazy. And I know intellectually that's not correct. Like, I do know that's not correct. Yet, I continue to do that to myself. Maybe it's Catholic school guilt, Catholic school girl guilt or something like that, I don't know. But that is what I've been going through for the last little bit. And I just felt like I needed to come on today and tell you guys what's going on in my life, because I went from filming and having color and chats up every week to like having them up maybe once a week. So I'm sure you guys can understand, you know, where I'm coming from and why videos are a little scarce. I'm going to make a better effort to do more videos. But at this point in my life, I need to do them when I can instead of, you know, trying to pump out videos. Anyway, that's not ever really what I've ever been about, pumping out videos. So I'm just going to do things as I can, and I just wanted to make this video today to give you guys an update, at least some partial update for what we know at the moment. So, I've said so a lot in this video, but yeah, that's where we're at. And it's, I'm looking at it like this, even though I'm still trying to take it in and deal with it and recognize that, okay, we're going to have more challenges and stuff. I know it could be worse. Let's just put it like that. It could be a lot worse, and I don't even have all the answers yet. I can't even say it's not going to get worse. Let's pray that it doesn't. But, you know, in the grand scheme of life, this isn't the worst thing that could happen. This too shall pass, and I will learn to live with it, and hopefully once I see my pain management doctor and he has a better idea of what we're dealing with, we can work better together to come up with a plan for me. You know, even if it's like vitamins or, you know, he's a really, really smart man, so I trust him implicitly. And I know we will work together to figure this out. And in the meantime, my brother has a rheumatologist that he goes to that he really likes. So after I get the blood test results, I will go see that rheumatologist as well, since this kind of thing is their area of specialty. So that is my plan for the moment. So that's really it. That's the only thing that I really wanted to update you guys on. Not that I'm losing interest in coloring or making videos or whatever. That's definitely not it. Just more of a fact of not motivated to do it. I think deep down, this extra pain is getting me down a bit. It makes life harder. I've spent a lot of time lately sitting on the couch, just coloring or reading. When we go out to the park, I can't play with Emilio. You know, and I'm not trying to sing you my sad tune here. Don't get out your violin and play me a sad song. What do they call that? A dirge. Yeah, don't play me a dirge. That's not it. You're just hearing me at a time where I've been given some news that I didn't expect, and you know, just have to take it in, work it through my brain, accept it, and move on, and that's it. And everything is going to be okay. Like I said, it's just the initial, the whole thing about the loss of function that really kind of bothered me. And you know, I guess it bothers me too in a way, because I feel like I've been robbed so much of my life because of this fibromyalgia that now more could get taken away because of this arthritis. And that just blows. So at least I can laugh, right? But I'm not going to carry on the whole color and chat about my health. I just wanted to give you guys an update and tell you, you know, this is where we are, this is what I'm dealing with, this is why there's not as many videos as there used to be, but we've got more videos coming, I have plans, I just, you know, it's a matter of executing them and getting them off the runway, so to speak. And on that note, I'm going to change the subject because, you know, who wants to hear about this garbage the whole time? So how are you guys doing? Like I said, I've been on the Facebook page regularly. I'm following up with you guys. I set up a little post for you guys to buddy up with each other and do your buddy colors, which is pretty awesome. So many, I think last time I looked, there was like 140 posts on there, which is just awesome. That means all you guys are communicating and talking with each other. I love that. I love our group. And I said this before, and I'm probably biased, but I think we have the best group on Facebook ever. I don't care what kind of group it is. I think it's the best. Because there's no rules, like, except the only rule that I have is, like, no advertising. And my other rule is no, if you're streaming or anything, do not link it directly to the Facebook page. That is not okay. Other than that, I don't really have much rules. I just want everyone to get together, have a good old time, and, you know, if you need help and support or to vent, there's so many people there that are willing to listen, and I love that. I love that dynamic of our group. And I especially love when you guys get some happy mail and you share your pictures because, you know, even if I haven't gotten anything that week or whatever, it's so fun to see myself enabling you guys. Anne said, Jen loves to enable people. And she's right. And she hit on something about that was very intuitive of her. And she said, it's because Jen likes to see people happy, and that's the truth. And I know that when you guys get these lovely coloring supplies, it makes you so happy, and that in turn makes me happy. It's not so much the supplies that make me happy, although of course I love looking at people's supplies, who doesn't? It's the fact that you guys are happy and so excited about your things that really does it for me. So Anne, you're 100% correct on that. You're very wise, which I already knew. But I thought it was very nice that you threw that touch in there, that you realized that that is the reason that I like to see it. And the reason I like to enable you guys is because it makes you happy. And it makes me happy to see you happy. So we're all happy. What else did I want to talk to you guys about? There was something else. Oh, so let me go back to this book for a second, what I was talking about in the beginning. I ordered this book from, it's called printworksmarket.com. You're able to use your PayPal on there, so that's what I was able to do. And they shipped this to me super fast. I could not believe when it was at my door yesterday that it was already here. So if you're contemplating ordering from there, because they have the new Maria Troll book, they have the Swedish version of Seasons from Hannah Carlson. I don't know if you guys want that or if you're waiting for the American one to come out in August. That's up to you, but if you don't want to wait and you want it now, you can get it on this website. I had no problems at all. Everything went smoothly, got exactly what I wanted, and came in no time at all. So for me as a customer, it was a great experience. I'm sure there are other people that probably don't have as good an experience, but for me, I enjoyed it. I thought it went really well. So again, it's printworksmarket.com. I'm not sponsored. It's just where I ordered from. So I love this book. You guys know I love Emily's books very much. I love that fairy tale book that I got for review. It's one of my favorites. I color in it regularly, and I was hemming and hawing on this one, and I finally just ordered it, and I'm so glad I have it. And I'm going to be coloring in this tonight. I I had a whole list of things to talk about, and then I start the camera, and then I go brain dead. What's up with that? But that is really all the story for right now. Like I said, this is going to be a kind of condensed color and chat. I just wanted to give you guys a brief update on where I stand with my health, and then, you know, should I get any additional news or any other things that are happening, I will give you those updates as they come in. But, oh, another thing I wanted to talk about before I end this color and chat for today. I've said this on the Instagram stream, but maybe some of you guys might not watch that, so I'm going to say it again. Shalene and I think Shalene still wants to do it. I'm not sure. If she doesn't, that's fine. I'm still doing it no matter what. But we are planning a Christmas color in July. So it's going to be coming up very soon, obviously. We're already halfway through June. And I know for sure we're going to be using Joanna Basford's Christmas book for one of it. I think we're going to make it like a month-long event, color Christmas stuff, and listen to Christmas music and have fun things to Christmas things to do, like have hot cocoa and I don't know. I'm scared if Frank finds out that I'm doing coloring Christmas in July because he may put our tree up because Frank does stuff like that. You guys know Frank. So I can't guarantee that I won't have a tree up in July. So stay tuned. But so we are going to be doing like a month-long Christmas in July thing. I don't know if Shalene wants to do it for a month. If she doesn't, I will just continue it on for the month on my channel. But we're going to be doing this, and we haven't worked out the whole details yet. But I know, like I said, that one book we're definitely going to use. It was something that I've had in my mind since I came up with the idea for the Christmas color in July. So if you don't have a copy of Joanna Basford Christmas book, please go get it so you can join in with us. And like I said, we'll give more details as they become available. But that's going to be so exciting. I am really looking forward to doing a color in July. Obviously I haven't done that because I wasn't in coloring in July last year. I wasn't into it, but I'm into it now, and I'm so excited for it. I'm going to be listening to Christmas music. You can get Christmas music on Pandora. I don't have to drag out all my Christmas CDs and stuff. So I'm just really looking forward to it, and I hope you guys will all join in with us and do a little Christmas coloring. And that is really all that I have to talk about today. I would like to know what some of your requests are for future videos. I did a Inktense, not a tutorial, but a how I use Inktense in my last Instagram stream. I will be streaming again this Thursday, 7 p.m. Eastern Time on Instagram. All you need to do is follow me over there, and at 7 o'clock when I go live, my icon will be at the top of your Instagram page, and it'll say live next to it, and all you have to do is click in that, and then you can join and chat with everybody. And then for those of you that can't be there, I do upload them to YouTube, so even if I'm doing something on there and you were there, but you would like to rewatch it, you have that opportunity to do that. So I have so much fun doing the streams. I only stream for about an hour, maybe a few minutes over, but for the most part, it's an hour stream, and it's a lot of fun. We have so much fun chatting and enabling each other and talking about stuff and coloring, and people ask me questions, and it's nice to have that real-time interaction. Not that color and chats here aren't fun. They certainly are, but I can sit down when I'm doing that too, whereas like when I'm doing this, I can't sit because I need to stand by the island and do this. But so I'll be doing that. I can't believe today's Wednesday already. I'll be doing that tomorrow, Thursday night. And I think that's about it for this color and chat. I know I just did leaves on this one, but like I said, I just wanted to pop on, do a, you know, an old time color and chat for you guys. Tell you what's been going on with me, and let you know that I still am doing YouTube. I'm just working through some stuff, and we will get there and get back to our regularly scheduled programming. So let me zoom back out. I think I just gave myself a really nice paper cut. So here's what we got so far. The cute little mice reading a story in their big comfy chair. Leaves are coming out real nice. I wanted to do them that really like kind of lightish color, but just because this book is really whimsical, I feel like it calls for that. So that is that. And that's it for now. So Frank is on his way home. He'll be home any minute now, and I need to go. So I hope you guys enjoyed this. And I hope you'll join me tomorrow for my live stream. If not, I will see you in my next video. And thank you for joining, and happy coloring.